So if you've been on YouTube for a while, you may have seen these videos by HAI and RealLifeLore about the furthest distances you can walk on Earth. And while these channels and their videos are great, I'm sad to say they're dead wrong. They even came up with different answers for the longest route, and still managed to both be wrong. Since attacking bigger craters might get me some clout, let's talk about the real longest distance you can walk on Earth. If you just take a look at a map and try to eyeball the furthest distance you could walk, you'd probably pick two opposite corners of this big blob of land, either from the edge of Europe or Asia, all the way to the edge of Kamchatka. From Sagres, a small town located on the very southwestern tip of Portugal, all the way to the port city of Magadan in eastern Russia, that would be just over 9,000 kilometers as the crow flies. Unfortunately, you're not a crow, and you'd have to actually walk more than 14,000 kilometers through 8 countries and ascending and descending more than 74,000 meters. That's the equivalent of walking up Mount Everest and all the way back down, and then doing that 8 more times. This trip would take almost 3,000 hours of continuous walking, meaning it would probably take at least 3 years to walk all at once, assuming you weren't arrested, killed, or froze to death along the way. Unfortunately, the other obvious route is even longer, coming in at just under 16,000 kilometers direct, or more than 22,000 kilometers on foot, going through an extra 30,000 meters of elevation. The trip would take about 50% longer, taking you through 14 countries, including some of the most dangerous countries in the world, and sneaking across several borders in the Middle East. Now, this is the route that Real Life Lore comes up with. And sure, it's the longest distance you can walk 100% of the time, and if Google Maps is literally your only source. But this isn't the longest distance you can walk, not by a long shot. At this point, you've already walked across 2 continents, so why not just keep going? Why stop at Russia, and why not just keep going into the Americas? Now, I know that all you geography nerds might be thinking, what about this body of water? Are we supposed to just walk right across it? Well, yes you are. The Bering Strait that cuts between the two world superpowers, tucked into the very edges of maps, is only 80 kilometers long, and that's nothing for the ultra athletes considering this route. Keep in mind, there are races like the Go Big Race, where contestants only have 96 hours to complete a 400 kilometer journey encircling the main island of Hawaii. But those 400 kilometers are across solid ground. So what about this? Well, average temperatures across the Bering Strait routinely reach negative 30 degrees Celsius, cold enough for even ocean water to freeze. But strong ocean currents flowing north through the strait typically prevent it from freezing over. But every so often, if conditions line up just right, it will freeze over. 2 notable successful crossings have happened in the last 2 decades. The first was in 1998, when a Russian father and his son tried to walk across the strait from Russia to Alaska. As the ice started to crack, they became marooned on a floating piece of ice for 3 days before it eventually drifted across the strait, and the men, although non-ideally, managed to cross the strait on foot. Another crossing that went slightly better to plan was in 2006, when English adventurers Carl Bushby and Dmitry Keffer succeeded in doing the reverse route, walking from Alaska straight across to Russia, where they were immediately detained by Russian authorities for entering the country illegally. Factoring in this crossing, you could extend the longest route an additional 17,000 kilometers, walking through Alaska, Canada, down to Central America, taking the walkway over the Panama Canal, and going through the Amazon to get to the southern tip of South America. There are some tricky parts to this route, like walking along the Trans-Alaska Highway in freezing conditions, although by this point you've already crossed the Russian tundra, so maybe this part isn't actually so bad. Plus, you can always try to do it in the summer. From there, it's pretty much smooth sailing all the way down to Panama. In fact, a lot of people have walked from all across the US all the way down to Panama just for fun, and refugees have done the same route in reverse. At this point, you'd meet one of the toughest obstacles of the entire journey. Despite having already walked 30,000 kilometers, this 100 kilometer stretch between Panama and Colombia will be one of the most difficult. The Panama-Colombia border is one of only half a dozen borders around the world that don't share a road between them. Keep in mind, for almost the entirety of this journey, we've just been walking along major roadways. There's a handful of geopolitical reasons for this, but the end result is that this crossing will be difficult. Cutting between Yaviza in Panama and Crepa in Colombia lies the Darian Gap, a remote, roadless swath of jungle on the border of Panama and Colombia, filled with anacondas, poisonous frogs, black caimans, and plenty of drug smugglers. It is Colombia after all. If you manage to get through the pass, It's a straight shot all the way down the continent to the tip of South America. One journey that took almost 40,000 kilometers. Now this route might seem impossible. After all, it's really more of a thought experiment. But Carl Busby and Dmitry Keffer, the two men that crossed the Bering Strait, are actually trying to complete a similar route, trying to circumnavigate the world on foot, and they've already completed about 20% of it. This route is so ridiculous, Google Maps won't even display walking along the Alaska Highway as a walkable option, despite it doing the same for similar roads in Russia. So yeah, if you're trying to get in shape, consider trying out this route. Be sure to let us know what you think of the video or what other topics you want to see us discuss down in the comment section below. And remember, there is always more to learn.